local coverage you can count on continues with Glenn Marini's Sports Report. Sports coverage you can count on.
On Monday, it was on. On Tuesday, it was canceled. On Wednesday, it was, you know, on the way back to being on. And then on Thursday, it was on again. And then on Friday, well, they just showed up and, you know, beat their rival 36-0. And thanks to COVID, nobody's ever really had a week quite like that of the Southwood football squad. It's a reason we're proud to honor the Knights as your Optimum Performance Sports Team of the Week.
I'm Dr. Ian Nelson with Fort Wayne Orthopedics and Ops, wishing a congratulations to this week's Team of the Week. Great job, team.
Welcome back to another Team of the Week. I am joined virtually with head coach of the Southwood Knights, Coach Dave Snyder. Coach, what a week it was for you guys last week. A lot of drama building up to last week's first round of sectionals on Friday night, starting with heartbreaking news on Tuesday. Why don't you walk us through that?
Well, on Tuesday, I'd received a text from one of our players. They had tested positive for COVID. I contacted the school officials. We met by probably 2:30, a quarter to three, after talking with the health department. They had strongly advised us that we need to close the program down. So at that point, you know, we got a message out to the kids. It was very disappointing because we hadn't even got to meet with them. And then Wednesday evening at about 6 o'clock, I got a call that there was a possibility we could play, and there were some things we had to go through get done to do that. And one of them being that we had to test to make sure that we had more positives, and we had to get this done by Friday morning. So I got the results of the last young man that was tested Thursday afternoon, and I immediately called my wife. So we were just, you know, we were tickled we got the opportunity to go ahead and compete.
Just having the opportunity to compete was going to be enough for you. But really, the icing on the cake was what happened on Friday night. Without much practice, how sweet was that victory considering everything that led up to it prior in the week?
Yeah, it was pretty cool. When I talked to the kids, when we first got back on Friday, you know, and we got our meetings, and I said, you know, we're not going to talk any motivational here because I know you guys are so anxious to play. You know, number one, Northfield's a big rival, but just getting that second chance. You know, we talked to them about in life, second chances don't come along very often, and you know, you got to take advantage when you get that second chance.
As far as it looks, you're going to get to play this Friday, but still some challenges. You're not out of the woods quite yet. Tell us a little bit about what precautions you're having to go through this week in order to continue to play in the postseason.
Kids are all quarantined. We have two coaches on the staff that teach. They're quarantined. Quarantine meaning that we're not allowed to school. We can come in tonight at 4 o'clock after everybody's gone. Cars will have to be parked so that nobody can come in. And we're not allowing anybody to come practice. Unfortunately, that's why we're doing this. And we just have to stay very close knit. So we're just really thankful that we can still compete, that we can get a chance to play again this Friday. And we're willing to follow whatever precautions they want us to follow, because you do the health and safety of the players comes first.
Well, congratulations to the Southwood Knights, battle-tested, COVID-tested, and still making a push in the postseason. The Knights are your OPS Team of the Week.
And check out the Southwood Knights this coming Friday on the Highlight Zone. It's one of the featured games we'll see in Week 11 here on WANE-TV. That does it for sports. I'm Sports Director Glenn Marini.